Hello dear students, today we will discuss a story written by Mohan Rakesh. The title of the story is In Passion's Shadow. Basically, the story is written by Mohan Rakesh in Hindi. Mohan Rakesh is the Hindi writer and from Hindi, the story is translated into English. Let us begin this story. In this story, there are three main characters. Who are these three characters? The narrator. Narrator is a person who is narrating, who is telling us the story. You can say narrator, that means a writer as far as this story is concerned. Because in this story, this narrator, the person who is telling us a story, is a part of the story. The second character is Pushpa. Pushpa is a village girl. And then the third character is Pushpa's father. So, there are three characters in the story. The narrator, the person who is telling us the story, Pushpa, village girl, and Pushpa's father. Let us try to see some other details of these characters. Let us begin with the narrator. The narrator is a young person. He is working as the assistant supervisor in the secretariat. Our narrator is working as the assistant supervisor in the secretariat. He is getting a salary of rupees 120 per month. Well, friends, the writer, when he has written the story, in those times, this amount of 120 rupees per month, it was supposed to be a huge amount. What was the salary? At that time, he was getting salary of rupees 120 per month. Our narrator is young and he is a graduate. One more important information about our narrator is that he is a bachelor. That means he is still unmarried. And he is looking for a suitable girl. He wants to get married and he is in search of a suitable girl. The next character in our story is Pushpa. Pushpa is, as I told you, a village girl. She is 13 or 14 years old. She does not go to school. She is innocent and she is beautiful. In the story, we see that the writer has used so many phrases to describe the innocence and beauty of Pushpa. Here are some of the examples. At one point, the narrator tells us that the eyes of Pushpa are like thin sea shells. That means the eyes are very small and lovely. At another point, the writer says that wherever Pushpa goes, wherever she goes, she will give birth to poetry. That means the beauty of Pushpa is the subject of poetry. Such kind of beauty is there with Pushpa. Or the narrator says, she has not yet learned to blush like a young girl. Now, this sentence indicates that Pushpa is still an innocent girl. One more statement about the beauty and innocence of Pushpa is, she is living in the village with the yellow sarso flowers. Flowers, the sarso flowers that usually we find in the northern India. The color of flowers is yellow color. We find these colors particularly in the countryside, the rural, in the rural landscape. And the writer says that those yellow sarso flowers were her playmates. That means as if Pushpa was a part of a landscape, a part of a nature, because she was still very, very innocent. Now our third character is Pushpa's father. Pushpa's father is a tall, old Jat. Jat is a particular community that we find in Punjab. In other words, we can say that he was a Sardarji. He had sharp pointed beard. Being a Sardarji, he was having a beard. And as far as his eyes were concerned, he had the bloodshot eyes. That means his eyes were reddish in color. Pushpa's father, he was a zamindar. He had 4 acres of land in the nearby village and 5 acres of land in Karnal district. So he was a wealthy person, he was a rich person. He claims himself to be a Nabardar of the village. Nabardar, that is a village headman, serpents we can say. He was having a cow and 2 buffaloes. And one more important thing about Pushpa's father is that his wife is dead. This is how we see that there are 3 characters in our story. The narrator, Pushpa, and Pushpa's father.